what happened at the Twin Towers. Hillary has a disease of her brain. Interestingly enough, she is not the only official or person who has worked closely with Obama to have suffered an issue with the brain. If we look at the picture here, we see several individuals who are closely linked to Obama who have developed brain anomalies, and some of them have died. Starting in the lower corner, Joe Biden has a history of brain aneurysms, yet his condition was almost never discussed by the lamestream media during the 2008 election. His son, Beau Biden, a rising star in the Democratic Party, and somebody who spoke at the 2008 convention for Barack Obama, died of a brain tumor just recently. The next picture up, you see Republican Arlen Specter, who was the 60th vote to pass Obamacare. He suffered from brain cancer and ended up dying of a third bout of cancer in 2012. Obama's Commerce Secretary John Bryson crashed his car after suffering a seizure and had to resign. Like his fellow secretary Hillary Clinton, he was also diagnosed with complex partial seizures in 2012. Chief Justice John Roberts, responsible for passing Obamacare in the High Court on two occasions, is known to take extended leave of absence due to his condition of epilepsy. Pope Francis received a barrage of attention just last year in the fall after meeting with Obama. It was leaked that Francis was suffering from a benign brain tumor and that he was undergoing secret treatments by a Dr. Fukushima who had flown over from the United States to treat him. Dr. Fukushima is a neurosurgeon who is seen greeting the Pope in public at the Vatican. Jimmy Carter was the only U.S. president to endorse Obama in the 2008 election, until Bill Clinton finally did it at the convention. He also famously claimed that anybody who opposed Obama and Obamacare are racist. Carter, who was commonly listed as one of the worst presidents in U.S. history, was diagnosed with a secondary metastatic brain tumor and is currently under treatment. Harry Reid, the majority leader who was instrumental in passing Obamacare in the Senate, has suffered repeat falls, concussions, and black eyes since 2010. Some sources have speculated that, like Clinton, Reid might actually be in the early stages of dementia. Edward Kennedy was an early supporter of President Obama. It is said that his endorsement resulted in the downfall of Hillary Clinton in 2008. After his endorsement of Obama, Kennedy developed a primary glioblastoma brain tumor, which he would die of. As a part of his endorsement, Kennedy said that Obama had promised to focus on passing a healthcare bill. Kennedy had to be taken out of Obama's inauguration event because he suffered a seizure. According to sources, Ted Kennedy was the main reason why Obamacare passed the Senate after meeting many obstacles. Ted Kennedy is now dead. Their boss in the middle, however, might be the biggest enigma of them all. Not long ago, it was Barack, who was the source of unusual rumors that something appeared to have gone wrong with his head as well, just like Hillary. The head wound was apparent on photographs, clearly showing that Obama has had an open brain surgery performed while he was in office. I have treated numerous patients who have had surgeries carried out on their heads called craniotomies. Craniotomies are used for a variety of reasons, such as a tumor resection or for cases of trauma. When these surgeries are performed, a cut is made in the bone to allow the brain to swell. Sometimes the bone is removed. This is called a bone flap, which allows the brain to increase in size until the inflammation goes down. This keeps the brain from swelling too large inside the skull, which can push down on the brainstem, causing an irreversible condition called brainstem herniation. When the brain is back to normal size, the bone flap is glued back into place, but sometimes the bone is replaced with titanium plates. Whatever surgical operation was performed on Brock's head does not appear to be isolated. You can see that there are three surgical incisions. The largest is a right frontal parietal temporal craniotomy. There is also a large occipital incision and an obvious left temporal incision. His skull appears to have sustained massive trauma or something else that involves the entirety of his head. The scars indicate that Brock underwent a huge reconstructive surgery at some point while he was in office.
There are people out there, especially in that newfangled think tank that is the blogosphere, who have suddenly become very, very interested in President Obama's hair. Did the president have brain surgery and not tell anyone? Or how is that, and if he did, how has that affected his thinking? Is that why he needs a teleprompter, people have asked online.
The truth will never be revealed to you. If you look toward a deceitful media, we have seen how they have handled Hillary. You must always look past their headlines to understand the real truth. They tell you what to believe to manipulate you into following their agenda.
I'm going to read for you a quote from a book called The Supernatural Worldview, Examining Paranormal, Psi, and the Apocalyptic by Chris Putnam. It's a really big, thick book. And on page 231, it talks about laboratory evidence for presentiment. Quote, the presentiment work done by Dean Radin at the Institute of Noetic Sciences is probably some of the most compelling to date. He designed a computer screen interface that flashes emotionally charged images mixed with mundane ones and recorded people's emotional responses to a randomized series of pictures selected by computer using a random number generator from a pool of around 700 images. These images, from a standardized set used in psychological experiments, reflects different emotional states: calm, positive, negative, sometimes violent, and erotic. 30 to 40 trials are repeated in one sitting, lasting around 15 minutes. Obviously, the more graphic the image, the higher the expected response evokes. To detect an emotional response, Radin measured skin conductance level. When we are aroused, we always sweat a little, and the moisture increases electrical conductivity on the skin. This electrodermal activity is easily measured. Other indicators are heart rate, blood volume, blood oxygenation, respiration, pupil dilation, blink rate, and eye movement. A more advanced method of using electroencephalography, EEG, and functional magnetic resonance imaging, fMRI, detection of brain activity has also been employed. These are all well-accepted experimental indicators of arousal within psychology. People consistently show an emotional response a few seconds or so prior to the evocative images. Even more interesting, the more intense images elicit a higher anticipatory response. Radin labels this the presentiment effect and believes the results to be evidence of retrocausation, another way of suggesting precognition, albeit reversed. So basically what it's saying is that the body responds to the image before the image is shown consistently. I'm going to continue on here. Quote, the data on the graphic is from one set of experiments, but is a good general illustration of how the effect works. Consistently, people are aroused 3 seconds before an evocative image is displayed. Radin has concluded several different studies on it with consistent results. His overall odds ratio was 125,000 to 1 against chance in favor of a real precognitive phenomenon. Radin's results were replicated by Dick Bierman, a psychologist at the University of Amsterdam. He did a fMRI study of 10 subjects that shows exactly what parts of the brain are firing in great detail. The amygdala, almond-shaped massive gray matter associated with fear, activates consistently during the presentiment period, and right brain activity is enhanced. In women, he found a presentiment effect for both violent and ironic images, but with men, Not too surprisingly, the effect was shown exclusively for the erotic content. His odds against change were 50 to 1. The presentment data is the strongest to date that nearly all of us have some latent paranormal ability, an idea Watchman Nee arrived at his from his reading of Genesis. End quote. And you can get all the citations and references from the book, The Supernatural Worldview. But that's a look into how the human mind has this power to construct reality. The mention of Watchman Nee there is really interesting because, as he documents in the book earlier, Watchman Nee believed that there are latent powers, psychokinetic powers that humans possess that was lost after the fall. And he suggests that, you know, we can tap into a remnant of it, but really that's not something we should be doing, and that's why God forbids witchcraft and all those things. But there is this original design element to this perceptive side of human consciousness. And I think that's true. I think something was different in the Garden of Eden, where God freely walked with us and among us. The translation of the word serpent is Nakash, which can be more accurately translated the Shining One. Satan, this rebellious angel, was a Shining One that could communicate openly with Eve, who was clearly made out of dirt because Adam was made out of dirt. So there you have it. There's evidence, proof that humans had this extra perceptory ability, and it was lost at the fall, and it remains through human imagination. And I think that's why science fiction appeals to us so much, because there is this deep inherent truth that resonates when you enter the world of science fiction, where possibilities are endless. And the scary thing, I think, with what is alluded to with the darkness, the dark side of this, is that it can manifest into our world in a very unsavory way.
Seems that massive amounts of people all around the globe are complaining that their iPhones are hissing. They actually say that it's hissing like a snake, hissing like a serpent. They're also telling us that it's nothing to worry about, just a little bit of a technical issue. iPhone 7 users have been reporting that their new smartphones have had quite the hissy fit, making a noise that sounds like a snake hissing in the grass. And I know all about the official story. The mainstream is already explaining all this for us, so there's no need to look anywhere else, right? It's just a technical problem. Just a glitch. So we should question everything. There's nothing wrong with questioning these mainstream stories and the mainstream answers to our questions. My question is, can demonic interdimensionals, can demonic activity, demonic energy, can it manifest through electronics? Demons, as we know them in Christianity, have the power to possess souls which are spiritual and not physical, though it's theorized by some that they are the cause of natural and unnatural disasters, and also the belief in spiritual possession of objects, stones, jewelry, statues, etc. I believe most Christians can agree that a demon can manifest itself into various, if not any, kind of a form. I absolutely believe that spirits of God and of Satan can have interference with electrical devices and energy-powered things. So I do believe that a demon can manifest or possess a TV or other electronic device as it can with anything else. And if a demon wanted to find a way to channel itself through something physical, like a TV, which of course utilizes almost all of the electromagnetic spectrum as well as being a physical object through which much potentially evil content is displayed to us, mankind in general, then it seems this would be a mega airport, so to speak, for trans-dimensional beings like spirits or demons. And of course, this in no way means that all electronics or televisions are bad. It's how we use it. It's always depending on the content. It's what you give your authority to. It's much easier to let in unwanted spirits when you expose yourself to bad and unholy things in this respect. But that's just my opinion. I'm curious to see what your opinion is. Do you think that demons or spirits in general can manifest through electronic devices? So back to the iPhone and this hissing sound that's coming out of the phones. So what kind of proof is there that there could be something else going on with the iPhone other than something technical? Is there any proof there at all? Throughout the years I've researched these kind of subjects and more, usually the bizarre, the strange, the unusual. And you can do this research for yourself, but there's multiple accounts from people that believe they've been possessed or that their homes have been possessed. There's multiple accounts of these people having issues with their electronics around these times. They believe that somehow these evil spirits are manifesting through their electronics. This story of the iPhone 7 hissing like a serpent reminded me of this story right here. It's fairly recent. It's about the Uber driver that wound up shooting several people, and he believed that the devil was possessing him through his Uber app. Jason Dalton, who allegedly gunned down his victims in between picking up fares, told detectives that an inverted multicolored pentagram known as the Eastern Star suddenly appeared on his smartphone, followed by a satanic image. Dalton acknowledged that he recognized the Uber symbol as being that of the Eastern Star, and a devil had popped up on his screen, and when he pressed the button on the app, that is when all the problems started.